Never been in one, and if you have been in one, I want to validate it for you. Generally, what occurs in an IEP meeting is that it is one parent, maybe someone else with the parent, if you're lucky, and then there are 6 or 7 administrators, representatives from the school. Now, when we talk about the federal law specifically states that an IEP has to occur on a mutually agreed upon location and a mutually agreed upon time, and that the parent has the federal authority to invite whoever they want. That means you can invite your grandmother, the dog, the cat. You can bring whoever you wish to the IEP meeting with you as your support and as a voice for your child. A lot of our families don't take advantage of that. Now with IEPplan.com, that will facilitate that process for you, because you'll be able to just send out an email to someone, whoever you want to come and be part of your community. Really, it's a virtual village, is it not?
It is a virtual village.
Basically, if you have anyone you want, especially our military families, which I'm dealing with right now, you have your military family, your mother, father deployed overseas. Just think of the opportunity they have to access the IEP just from an email. You will be able to upload your IEP, upload your 504 through a PDF format, which is what we're using. Schools are, and just so you know, schools are required to email you your IEP or your 504 plan if you request it. That is a federal law. They are required to do that under the digital FERPA management. So if they tell you we don't do that. Yeah, you do. You do. So
they've got to learn to do it.
So it, once again, these are rights that you have. You can have all of your information sent to you via email. And for a lot of families, that is the best way to manage your information. So when you join our group, IEPplan.com, whether it's registering with us, which we hope you register and become like us on Facebook. Mm-hmm. But when you join us, you will be able to be empowered to know what your rights are, and we will help you level the playing field to giving the parent their rightful advantage.
Yeah, and so, and I know that we talked about it before, but really this is a question of access, right? Mm-hmm. So when kids are marginalized within their schools and communities, they just don't have access to resources mm-hmm. to get them in a place where they can be successfully academically successful. And this is restoring that access, right? So when we talk about being able to look over and review and share your IEP plan, that's on your time. That's not according to, you know, someone else's schedule. That's not at 2 o'clock in the afternoon when you have to take time off from work to get someone to come in and give feedback. That's not realistic, and that's not reasonable, right? So again, this is giving you power that you don't even realize you have yet. And I think once you actually register, and I think right now we're talking and it seems, you know, like this is a lot to digest, mm-hmm. and I get it. But this is a really serious conversation. This is a serious model that we're addressing a serious need. So I really need for you all to, you know, not wait until, you know, you hear it again after, you know, a bunch of people have signed on and they've already gotten their information access. We spoke with a family in Fort Lee when we went out there a few weeks ago that said, I wish I would have spoken to you guys sooner at the beginning of the school year, because now their children are facing some issues that, you know, now it's going to take more time to try to undo. So get the information now. Be proactive, especially if you've been disengaged from the process so long because you just simply don't know. This is your time to act.
Well, the great thing too is that so many families have experienced this already with one or more of their children. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And then for the folks coming in new, the great thing about IEPplan.com and 504plan.com is that we build, not only give you a chance to build your own team and invite who you want, but also become part of a community of users. So if your children are in Richmond City Schools or Henrico County Public Schools or Chesterfield County Schools or whichever schools, you'll be able to join a group of like-minded parents and maybe even engage with folks that you didn't even know were out there in that community. And then the great thing is that for our military families, as we go from Fort Lee to Quantico to Fort Eustis to all over, and as you rotate in and out of your command rotations in one place or another, it'll be a great opportunity to continue to maintain your connection with those folks in that community, right, and find out who has had trouble in that area or not. I think that someone we met with here recently said it best, that you know, she was only one person and there are 1,000 people that she needs to be able to help. The great thing is that there are hundreds of families within that 1,000 family community that already have tremendous experience mm-hmm. that can help people begin to cope and respond quickly to those things. You know, one person can't do it all, but together we can do it. Together.
Exactly, that's exactly. Right. And when we also think of the groundbreaking nature of IEPplan.com, those of us that have been in special education for the last 15, 20 years, we understand that schools are not going to be ready for this. We have to be honest about it. Schools are not going to be ready, are not going to be ready for parents who are empowered and educated and have your own team. And so when you walk in there, it's going to command a certain level of respect and a certain level of, okay, they know what they're doing. And so we're basically, by implementing this whole process, we're raising the standard of quality for education regarding special education. In addition, we know that fundamentally, education is a civil rights issue. When we talk about special education, it's even more of a civil rights issue because of the federal protections that our families have. For instance, families are often told that they can't have anyone else in the meeting with them. Okay, you have a right to an advocate. That is a fact. The federal code, USC 20, it specifically states you have a right to an advocate. So when you're with our community and you send us a note or, you know, you're talking among your community and you start exchanging stories and talking about, you know, they said I couldn't have this, they said I couldn't do this. No, we want to go ahead and educate you on what your rights are. We're also inviting school systems to join us eventually, yeah. Correct? We want school systems to join us.
Well, and the reason for that is that they're obviously a part of the discussion too. They've been controlling the discussion up until now, and they have built really large, really expensive, really inefficient systems that parents aren't invited to participate in. And so parents needed their own tool to be able to organize their information and build their team. And we hope that the tool that we build will be enticing enough for the schools to realize that their system is way behind the curve mm-hmm. and that they don't need to spend millions of tax dollars building a system that they can manage the information. They can just simply join our system.
Exactly.
But the great thing is that it really puts the power back in the hands of the parents.
Yes.
It's really about the parents knowing their rights and understanding what the opportunities are and then being equipped to handle that. And the great thing is that when we had our first child, we went through the whole coaching process and understood we're going to tell the doctors what to do during delivery. Well, that didn't work out very well. But even though it didn't work out the way we planned, it still gave us the information that we needed. So the great thing is that even if nothing changes as an outcome, the fact that you've gone through the process of having other people engaged and being a part of that process and understanding what your rights are and understanding what's likely to happen, mm-hmm. Even if it doesn't change the specific future in terms of the plan looks like and what it includes mm-hmm. and doesn't include, at least having gone through the process, you've exercised your rights mm-hmm. and you've become more aware and you've engaged with the rest of the community. And that experience alone, as you share that, will be beneficial for other people in the community.
That's exactly right. And something you said, Gordon, you said, well, the schools have these, you know, high price systems
yes.
that don't allow or don't encourage the parents to participate. Well, you just said, even if this doesn't, no, let me tell you why this is gonna make such a huge impact.
Sure.
The Every Student Succeeds Act, mm-hmm. it is mandatory for parental participation. So right now we are ahead of the game. This is what the federal law requires. So this system is not only absolutely filling that need, listen, it behooves, you know, the school districts to come on board with us because, again, this is already in place and the efficacy of the process from start to finish. You're already a very solid businessman in this technology industry. You've worked with the military. Why wouldn't they? So, again, why wouldn't they?
They certainly would. But, the school may still do whatever the school wants to do as a result. The system itself and the community that we're building will have a tremendous impact on the process. That's for sure. And ultimately, we can advocate and we can push for all the rights that we want. the school may still, you know, hold fast to whatever position they have, and hopefully with enough momentum, then we can continue to make changes in that direction.
But
it's important that we try. I mean, we have to know our rights, we have to get organized, and we have to engage on our terms, on the parents' terms, not be controlled by the schools. Once you stand up for your own rights and say, I'm not going to be pushed around by insert your school's name here. I'm not going to be pushed around by this county school or this city school. Then they know that you are somebody to be reckoned with and not somebody who they can just tell what to do.
And it's so imperative to understand that we operate best for our children when we operate proactively. So when we're, usually by the time parents come to me, a whole lot has gone wrong. It's rarely that I receive calls from kindergarten, parents of kindergartners or first graders or second graders. Usually I have middle school and high school kids that who have had incorrect or inadequate IEPs for 6 or 7 years, and it has impacted the quality of their education to the point where it's very difficult to catch up and receive compensatory services. So I'm strongly encouraging, once again, if you feel as though there's a need, even if you don't have a need, register. Because the information that you have, you might be able to share with someone in your family, in your community, in your church. We're encouraging civil organizations. We just found out the NAACP is going to be signing up with us. We have information regarding, of course, we talked about the Fort Lee. We launched the website in our advocacy meeting for the state of Virginia, and we received a lot of questions from the Virginia Department of Education, which we know they should be registering as well. So we want all the stakeholders to be part of this community. And basically, this is going to be the Facebook of special education. That's what it's going to come down to. This is going to be the Facebook of special education. One of our national partners, Dignity in Schools, they have ran with this, and they're just promoting it as well throughout our 102 organizations that we have.
In 27 states.
if you think about the fact, too, that there's 180 school days a year, and if they have inadequate IEP plans for a significant majority of that time where they've lost as much as a third of that, the time that they would have benefited from some specific thing, then after 10 years of education, they've lost as much as 3 years of momentum. And it's important because everything they learn in first grade builds as they go into second grade. And everything they learn in second grade builds as they go into third grade. And if they've not been able to have the correct IEP plans for 2, 3, 4, 5 years, you've essentially lost a year worth of development in that process. And that's the thing that I think is so critical. The one thing we can't get back is all that time that the kids have lost. Because if we, most programs like in Virginia support birth through age 22. And at age 22, that's it. So by the time they've gone through the program for more than 21 years, and you look at a third of that time, they may be falling short of what they should have been getting through that process. That's 7 years. They've lost 7 years worth of potential that the kids just don't get back. And we couldn't sit around and just stand by and watch that happen anymore. Right. It was more than just making sure we were asserting our rights. It was providing a platform that empowered the parents, that recognized the federally protected rights and gave everyone a chance to build their own team and to make sure that your child gets the full benefit of every single thing they're entitled to.
The buzzword nowadays is accountability. We hear that buzzword a lot at the local, state, even federal level. Well, IEPplan.com is creating a culture of accountability. And we say that because when you have a lot of eyes, a lot of ears, and a lot of mouths, looking at one IEP and saying, okay, this is correct, that's correct, this is what we want to change, that is creating accountability, not only on the school's part, but on the parents' part. Mm-hmm. Because remember, the IEP process, special education, is a collaborative process. And everyone on the IEP team, despite what the school may tell you, everyone on the IEP team has a place. Now, I always share with our parents that the parent has the most power of anyone on the IEP team, because if you don't sign or give consent, informed consent, nothing happens. And so for our parents that feel as though, you know, I don't have any power, the school is going to do what they want to do, you're the ones I'm talking to that need to sign up today. Sign up with us now so that you can get what you need, to the empowerment that you need to be an advocate for your child.
And bottom line is,